I has cleavage.
Welcome back to Let's Play. My head hurts. I'll go back to sleep. Where were we anyway? And it's too late, it seems. Aoki pushes herself up from the table, rubbing her eyelids. Back asleep. What time did you go to bed?
8時.
That's a bit early.
普通だよ.
That's the one thing it's not. Anyway, eat up. We got school. Don't go to sleep. Wake up now, Yuki, or we shall troll you. Oh, just eat already. Urging her thus, I too grab a piece of toast. There's a row of jam jars on the table, but I stick to plain butter.
Yuichi, jam つけないの?
I'm not particularly fond of sweet things. You too, Yuichi! Okay, so he is a bit like Tomoya like that as well, like, nah, sweet things aren't my thing.
私はつけるよ!
And holding the jar of strawberry jam between her hands, she smiles with her sleepy eyes. I assume it's strawberry. It's red, although I can't see the label on the jar. The other jars are similarly plain. Maybe they're all homemade.
Ichigo jam, oishiyo!
Swaying her eyes still only half open, she spoons it out lavishly. I'll go to sleep.
Thank you.
Brrr, as she takes the jam smothered toast between her teeth, lighting up the corner. Don't go to sleep while you're eating. And as sleepily as she claims, she takes another bite. Bet on that. Munch, munch.
Oishi.
So happily.
私、いちごジャムがあったら、ご飯3杯は食べられるよ。
Stop saying scary things like that and eat up.
ゆういち、もう食べたの?
I can actually eat a slice of bread in under half an hour. Washing my toast down with coffee, I glance at Nayuki's plate. She's hardly made any progress. I'll wait for her to finish. Okay, I'm waiting for you, so be as quick as you can.
できるだけ急ぐよ。
Munch, munch. Crunch, crunch. Haven't you finished yet?
まだ3秒しか経ってないよ。
Right, eaten half of it for you.
え、いいよ。自分で食べるよ。
Too late. I swipe her toast, tear it in two, and shove one part in my mouth.
ひどいよ。
I return the other half quickly before she turns
violent. 私のいちごジャム。
Want me to eat it all?
ゆういち、嫌い。
She mutters this peevishly, gazing despondently, whatever, at the remnants of her breakfast. I wonder whether I might have gone slightly too far.
告白人だよ。
But probably not that far.
Pat on the head, woman, as I.
Will you hurry up? We enter the hall and hurriedly drag our shoes off.
行ってきます!
As I step outside, a blast of freezing air cuts into the hall. Another Arctic day.
お腹すいたよ。
Now speaking of like the whole cold snow here and stuff like that, recently snowing where I live. I wonder how much it'll snow for though. Because usually they're like, it's gonna snow a lot guys, and then it turns into rain instantly. Clutching her stomach as though suffering greatly, Nayuki staggers after me. What's the time? time?
8時 7分.
We should be okay walking then.
Mm.
You want to run to be sure?
お腹空いて走れないよ.
Well, fine, I suppose we have time.
Ichigo jam.
I turn Ayuki away from the house and its culinary associations, and we head to school.
Yuichi. Samui no, nareta?
This is my third day here. I'm hardly going to accumulate that quickly.
Demo, Yuichi datte mukashi wa koko ni sundetan dakara.
Too long ago. Look, I don't remember anything clearly from 7 years ago.
歩いたら思い出すよ.
I will.
あの時と同じ雪. 同じ街並みの中を歩いたらきっと昔のこと思い出すよ.
Mayuki?
Hmm?
Do I have to remember? That time, I mean. My cousin, my childhood friend, stares into space, her expression momentarily unreadable.
ゆういちに思い出してもらいたいって願ってる人が一人でもいるのなら思い出した方がいいと思うよ.
What's that supposed to be?
私も自分で言っててよくわからなかったよ.
With a laugh, with a shy smile, she turns to me.
お腹空いてるから変なこと言ったのかもしれないね.
That's right, find a way to blame me.
Ichigo jam.
Get up early if you want to eat slowly.
努力はしてるよ.
She murmurs as we walk on.
目覚まし時計増やそうかな.
No, I mean, you mustn't try that.
どうして?
Need to try that. Diminishing returns. Snow from the rooftops floats down on the north wind. The white streaks I didn't get much of a chance to look at them yesterday. I walk along beside Nayuki, savoring the view. Her head is bowed as in serious thought, but I detect traces of a smile on her face. At last, the school building appears before us. Ah, we aren't even late.
これで遅刻したら私がかわいそうだよ.
She looks up at me with an easy smile. True. We walk on inside, and as proclaimed, we're actually on time. The broad corridors are filled with other uniforms. All unfamiliar, of course. But among the crowd, I glimpse an odd face here and there that I vaguely recognize. My classmates, I assume.
Ohayo!
Ohayo gozaimasu, and all that.
Huh? Minase-san, ohayo!
Ohayo! Definitely a classmate, why am I talking
like this? Ohayo!
Recognizing me beside Nayuki, she greets me as well. Hey, oh. Momentarily at a loss for words.
ダメだよ, Yuichi. ちゃんと挨拶しないと.
Nayuki strikes again. Dozens of people must have heard that, and most of them are grinning. I even recognize most of them. Thank you! That should start a few nice rumors.
私何もしてないよ.
そうそう.
おはよう!
おはよう!
However long she's been listening, Kyori chooses this moment to make an entry and take Nayuki's arm.
Aizawa-kun, あんまり Nayuki-を困らせたらダメよ. Nayuki-のおかげでクラスに馴染んでるんだから、もっと感謝しないと.
I admit there's something in what Kyori says. I certainly have been into my class unusually quickly with her help at Nayuki's. That doesn't mean much to me. I'm used to being alone.
一人は寂しいよ.
うんうん.
Yori nods sagely at Nayuki's assessment. Frankly, I don't see how it's their business. Yori points down the corridor. Who is this Shiba? Ashi, whatever.
担任の名前くらい覚えておきなさいよ.
The whole class piles into our classroom in some confusion. Why should it matter if we know the teacher's name anyway? We don't know the freaking teacher's name in freaking Kanon, do we? At least I don't recall. We force our way through the rush of people hunting for their desks and prep and take our seats. It's times like this that the window people have a real disadvantage. Our teacher opens the door and morning registration begins. Nayuki beside me flashes me a smile. We may have made it today, but I fear we'll be failing soon. This comforting thought lasts me the rest of the period. At least till I learn something even more pleasant to contemplate. Namely that this semester's lessons will begin today. Yuck. My only comfort is that they release us at lunchtime on Saturdays.
Yuichi, 今日から授業だね。
I don't have any textbooks yet.
私の見せてあげるよ。
I'll pass. I imagine the scene, Nayuki and I not only sitting together but sharing our books. I imagine that what conclusions people would draw, I resolve to avoid.
でも、ないと困るよ。
教科書だったら、俺のを見せてやるぞ。
Hello! It's Sunohara's prototype! But, of course, he's a prototype. So, the hairstyle is slightly similar. Keyword, slightly. It isn't exactly the same. Eye color is different and all that. The English dub for Kanon and Kanon, the 2006 version of Kanon anyway, they both have the same voice actor. They're both idiots and stuff. But Kitagawa here, he's the prototype. He's only got this one freaking image. He has no other facial expressions in the entire thing. Also, I did actually see one fan art of like both Kitagawa and Sunohara in one image, and I'll show that at the end of this part, if I remember to. But anyway, let's get on with the scene. Someone else enters the conversation. He must have overheard us. Who are you?
昨日挨拶したぞ。
Did we? I don't remember a thing.
北川君だよ。
Right. Actually, I do seem to remember her mentioning a name like that.
覚えたって言ってたのに。
I have a special power of forgetting people's faces after 12 hours.
迷惑な特技だな。
Not at all.
まあいいけど。それで、教科書見るんだろ?
He seems a bit prone, but not particularly worried. What a nice guy. Thanks, but what about you?
いいも何も、後ろの席だからな。
You can't.
どうして真後ろの席に今まで気づかないんだ?
I try not to look behind myself.
変なやつだな。
Well, sorry.
大体だな。 普通は、 突然の転校生って言ったら、美女?
What? Of course it'd be like that, isn't it? Voice acting just like, as soon as you press enter to go to the next part of it, the voice acting just stops abruptly. Well, sorry.
まあいいけどな。 変なやつだから、授業中退屈せずに済みそうだしな。
I'm about to reply, but the bell cuts me off.
先生来たみたいよ。
This is a signal for a general migration of students back to their seats.
とりあえず、よろしくな。
That's what I'm gonna say every time I say yeah now, isn't it? Just like, Is that him right there, or maybe... I'm not entirely sure, to be honest, because when he showed him there, different hands, he doesn't have the thing coming up from there. Maybe he fell back there. No, that mustn't be him, actually, because that's the seat right behind Kayuki. So that... But at the same time, I have no idea, to be honest. Probably not Kitagawa, but... similar kind of look to him, slightly. Okay, maybe not. Whatever, let's just continue. The boring lessons begin, and time drags on. I've been bored before, but now I'm faced with incomprehension on top of boredom. The curriculum differs between schools, and here I seem to be rather behind the rest of the class. Sleepy, but I wouldn't be to do it to fall asleep so soon at a new school. So I twiddle my pencil and wait for the teacher to shut the hell up. And as the second half of the school hour approaches... You know what? The freaking teacher is very downgraded here, isn't he? Look at that design. It's so lazy, man. He doesn't have a face or anything. I mean, at least the one in Kanon actually has a face. This guy doesn't even get a face. He gets a name, but no face. The one in Kanon, no name, but he gets a face. Maybe he did get a name as well. I'm not sure. I have no idea. Also, I noticed this freaking, line right here on the blackboard.
Yeah, it's good to be back in my original environment.
Shabby old blackboard. Kitagawa behind me puts me in the back with his pencil and whispers this. Well, of course this is a school.
Yeah, so じゃなくて.
Whatever. With this ambiguous reply, I glance sideways at Nayuki. Well, that's a surprise, she's fast asleep. Hasn't she been asleep for half the day already? Another poke, another whisper. Yeah, why doesn't the teacher notice her snoring? I'm too polite to just ignore him, so I turn and provide this encouragement. Don't try me freaking Botan's followed me even here. He points out the window. I peer out over the windowsill. Better not be you, Botan! Through the glass. Better not be you! Outside is the area behind the school building. Empty, covered in fresh snow, it's a pretty bleak sight. Scene, whatever. Without even footprints to show where people have been. Well, there is one set of tracks. Better not be yours, Botan! At the end of them, a lone girl standing there. Oh, it's not Botan, of course not. Hands together in front of her, almost motionless, staring into the snow. Looks like she's waiting for something. You know what? I haven't really paid much attention yet, but those chairs don't look particularly comfortable, do they? What the hell's with the design on those chairs? I can't be sure at the distance, but she doesn't seem to be in uniform. What, a student? Waiting for someone? Or looking for something? But these guesses are futile, it's not like I can open the window and ask her. She'll probably leave soon. The sun may have come out, but it's still too cold to stand around like that for long. You know, that'd be funny, wouldn't it? Just open the window in the middle of class and be like, "Oi, you are down there! Who the hell are you and why are you there?"
そうだよな.
With this noise of consent, he removes his eyes from the window. I can hardly carry on staring out now that he's stopped, so I turn away. Man, I need a drink. Nayuki is still in the middle of her pleasant dream. At last, the chime of the bell brings the second hour to an end.
Yuichi!
Oh, you're awake?
Watashi neteta?
Like a log.
Ikenai. Mata nemutchatta yo.
Excuse me, Nayuki, I need a drink. Anyway, what do you want?
今日部活お休みだから一緒に帰ろうと思って。
I promise. And as I nod, the bell rings. fanfare of glass begins. Oh man. 4 hours? Screw that. Today being Saturday, this is the last period. I sit patiently through the lesson, letting it wash over me, preoccupied with other things. Outside the window, there below, where the lone girl stands amidst the unchanging snow. Wasn't it 2 hours ago we noticed her? She still hasn't moved. As much as clearly visible from the tracks in the snow ice. A single row.
Oi, Aizawa!
And a gal behind me leans forward.
Anoko mada iru zo.
Yeah. He whispers worriedly. And as much as one can judge from such an angle and distance, she looks like a young girl. Her skin as white as the snow. Nothing would justify waiting at a place like that. What's that? As I watch, I notice a faint haze in the air around her. Sounds silly, but I'm somehow relieved by this evidence that the girl is breathing. Finally, the bell sounds the end of the day's lessons. The girl outside looks up, as though that's what she'd been waiting for. I know that face, the girl I met in the snow. I just remember something, I need to go. I'm due, whatever. Standing up, running out.
Oi! Mada home room ga nokotteru zo!
I'll be back in a moment. Stop. Ignoring further shouts from Kinagawa, I enter the corridor. Running past the startled few people present, I take the stairs in bounds. The scene visible outside the window is white and lewdly. Running down the corridor, I look for the metal doors I saw yesterday. They must lead to the area I seek. As I push open the door, a gust of freezing wind blows in from outside. I force the cold, heavy doors open and leap outside. The air, incomparably colder than inside, bites into my skin wherever it's uncovered. Freezing! Narrowing my eyes around the dazzling reflections, I look around. The second-year classrooms must be over there. The school grounds are ridiculously large. Of course, it didn't lead to the quad. If the area below the window actually is a quad. Nevertheless, I pick a suitable direction and begin walking. What am I doing? This question provokes a deep sigh. I plod on, my body confirming with every step that yesterday was indeed warm. Soon the back of the school building shrouds my view. Here I am. Rocking like a hurricane! No, shut up. Anyway... see you next time, viewers. I'm gonna put that random image that I mentioned earlier on in this part. And yeah, see you next time, viewers. See you next time.